Hello everyone! In this video you can watch me make a geode ornament. And first I'm going to color the inside with mica pigments. And after drying I'm going to fill it with acrylic crystals to create the look of a real geode crystal. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin, acrylics, mixed media, alcohol ink, and a lot more tutorials, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because if you select all then you don't miss any future videos that I will be uploading to my channel. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to make a geode ornament. You can display it for Christmas ornament, but also if it's not Christmas. But I'm using a plastic ornament and it's 12 centimeters, so rather large. And I'm going to make it the same way as it is with the glass ornaments. So I'm using a gloss varnish first. I already added it on the inside of my plastic ornament. And now I'm going to add gum arabic, and this is a binder that you normally use to make your watercolors, but I'm using it on the inside of my plastic ornament to create some nice effects, because after this I'm going to add some mica pigments, but first the gum arabic. There you can see it. I taped the large hole that is already in the plastic ornament, because otherwise the powders will blow up in my face if I shake it. So that's why I have some tape, and this way I can make the hole smaller. So you will see the whole process in this video, up until the end result at the end of this video. So now I'm starting with the mica pigments. I'm starting with a nice pink color. Again, I'm adding it to the inside of my plastic ornament. And this ornament is in two halves, so you can how do you say that in English? Yeah, it's in two halves. But if it's totally done, then it's all sealed and well, and they don't come loose anymore. So now I'm going to shake it to create some nice effects, to mix the gloss varnish and the gum arabic together with the mica pigments. Now I'm using a purple mica pigment. This is one of my own natural mica pigments. It's the Crocus Magic. I think that looks nice together with the pink. And again, I'm going to shake it, putting a piece of paper on top of the hole so that the pigments stay in my plastic ornament. There you can see it. And it looks already nice. There you can see it. And the next color is a blue-green color. Also adding it to the inside. All the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box below this video, with the links to the websites, as I always do. Yeah, it looks nice already. Colors go very well together. A little bit more. Shaking it again. Yeah, it looks nice. done with the mica pigments. A little bit closer. There you can see it, a little bit closer, nice effect. So I need to let this dry before I can start on the next step. Yeah, it looks great. So it's dry on the inside, now I want to change the hole, and I'm using a, yeah, I don't know the name for this tool, but it gets very hot and you can melt the plastic away. I must say I'm standing outside and you see a lot of smoke. I'm also wearing a mask because this smells a lot and I don't think it's very good for your health. So that's why I'm using my mask, my safety mask. So I'm cutting away some plastic, I'm melting away some plastic to create another shape of the hole. Because if I want to create a real look of a geodesic stone, then the hole is not straight or as it was. So that's why I'm changing the hole. Sorry that it's not totally in focus. And it dried very well, the mica pigments. Some nice effects, you can see it already. And I'm going to work on the edge of my plastic ornament. I'm using a glue that's designed for use with gold leaf, because I want to add some gold leaf on the edges. And what I want to mention is also I got inspired by making this ornament by Sue Findlay. I will add the link to her video in the description box, so all the credits go to Sue Findlay, because she made a smaller geode ornament and I liked it very much. So I will add a link to that video in the description box. So now I'm going to add the gold leaf on top of the edges. There you can see it. Very carefully pressing it down into the glue. So this way, if you color the inside of the plastic ornament with mica pigments, then you don't have to do that on the outside. So I thought it was much easier to first color the inside and then add the acrylic crystals after that. And it looks nice with the gold leaf on the edges. Again, I'm using a very soft brush to press in the gold leaf into the glue. Also a little bit over the edge. I think that looks nice. Almost done with the gold leaf, then again go to the next step. Here you see me color the acrylic crystals with some Bombay ink. So first I'm adding the resin, then a few drops of the Bombay ink. In this case I'm using the Aqua. It's a nice blue-green color, then I'm mixing it around to color all the acrylic crystals, and I'm using different shapes and sizes. And what I must say, the plastic ornament is rather large. It's 12 centimeters, so you need a lot of acrylic crystals to fill it. Now I'm adding a little bit of my own natural mica pigment. It's the Sparkle White, to give it some sparkle. So what I said is that you need a lot of acrylic crystals if you use such a large plastic ornament, so you can also use a smaller one. But I have a lot of acrylic crystals, so for me that's no problem. There you can see it, adding it to the inside. And I'm using the Resin Pro Art Pro Deluxe. It's a thicker resin. With my spoon I'm adding all the crystals to the inside, pressing it against the sides. Yeah, and I'm not going to fill it all the way to the top in all places, because I want to create that dip that a real acrylic crystal also has. Now with my stirring stick I'm pressing it against the sides. And there need to be a lot more crystals in it. Adding more. Yeah, and what the process is that I'm going to fill it almost all the way to the top. Only in the middle there will be a dip. And after half an hour of my setting time, I'm going back, and I, because then the resin is already setting, and then I can press it more against the side, and then it will stay hopefully where I press it, because now you can see that it all falls down because the resin is too thin. Again, going to press it against the sides. Now I'm adding smaller crystals, also a lighter shade, so not that much drops of the Bombay Ink Aqua. There you can see the crystals fall down. The resin is still too thin, so it needs to set more before I can press it all the way down to the side so that it will stay. So the resin is getting thicker now, adding now clear acrylic crystals, also very large ones, to recreate the look of those real crystals that you see in a geode stone. Yeah, and I think it already looks very nice with all those crystals. It has some nice contrast and a lot of sparkle. I'm adding some glass glitter, white glass glitter, to give it even more sparkle. There you can see it. Yeah, I think it looks great. Also adding some very dark, smaller crystals for the contrast. So I added a lot of Bombay ink with a little bit of resin. Yeah, at the end of this video you can see a close-up, and then you can see the sparkle much better and the different colors of crystals. again, some glass glitter in the middle. Also some acrylic crystals on the edge. So my resin is getting thicker. So we are 30 minutes further in time, and the resin is already setting, so that's why I can add those large crystals, and yeah, it looks great. So let me know what you think of this look, but I think it looks amazing. There you can see it, I'm adding clear acrylic crystals in different sizes. And I also want to take some time to thank my monthly sponsors. I want to thank Evelyn for sending me such nice supplies, but also Dolores and Laurie and Michelle for sponsoring me each month. I appreciate it a lot, and it helps me to buy materials to make these videos for you all. So thank you so much. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. Also, Molds and Shapes, I want to thank for sending me their amazing molds, silicon molds. And also Resin Pro Company for sending me the nice resin supplies. So thank you all so much for doing that. I appreciate it a lot. So there you can see it. Added more clear acrylic crystals. I think it looks great. It sparkles a lot. So we are 24 hours later, and this is the end result. I have it outside in the daylight. It's so difficult to film this because it sparkles a lot and my camera can't focus, but I'm trying. So there you can see all the different acrylic crystals and the colors I've used, and also the nice gold leaf edge. Let me know what you think of my Geode Christmas ornament. I think it looks amazing. Also, the outside of my plastic ornament looks really great with the mica pigments. There you can see it, the nice different effects. So if you like what I'm doing, don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video. I appreciate it a lot, and it helps my channel a lot. All the information to the supplies I've used you can find in the description box below this video. And also the link to my Facebook, Instagram pages. And also my Etsy shop, where you can find my mica pigments. Also the Etsy shop of my associate Evelyn Schaefer, for the people in the USA and Canada. You can also find the link to my Amazon influencer store in the description box. So there's a lot of information. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!